Hi everyone, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to simulate an internet TV. So I have to create two classes first. One is called the network device, and the second one is called the television class. And I will create some methods for each of the classes. And then I will derive the internet TV class from the above classes. And I will also add some new methods pertaining to internet TV only. First, we need to create a class for the network device. I will create initializer first. MAC number and the cache size are the two variables required to initialize a network device object. I simply create two instanced variables for the network device object. MAC number here and cache size here are the two instance variables of a network device object. So these two variables will be having the values equal to the variables passed to the initializer. Then I can create a method for a network device. I can tell the network device to do data transmission. I would request a download if I want to tell the network device to transmit data. And that network device is also able to receive data. We have a variable to pass to the receive method. If the data required to receive is larger than the cache size of the network device, we have to do something. We stop the receipt of data because the packet size is too large. We will return false as well. That means this receive method will have a return value, which is a Boolean variable type. Else we do something. We will return true as the value of the receive method. Okay, this completes the network device class. We can also create the television class similarly. We have to set up the initializer first. A television has a screen as well as a volume tuner. Here, self refers to the television object. When we create an object later, this object will be passed automatically for us to the initializer. So it is not a variable that we need to handle when we really call the class to generate an object. We will see the object instantiation process later. Okay, I have two instance variables for a television object called screen and volume tuner. And these two instance variables have the value obtained from the initializer. A television can display video. How can I do that? And when I want to display a video with a television, I will print a statement out. Displaying video on a certain screen provided by the initializer of the television object. A television can also change its volume. That means I can make the sound produced by the television louder or quieter. If the change volume parameter is less than zero, I will do something like this. That means I want to reduce the sound by some amount. Okay, if the amount is negative, I will print a statement to tell the user that the sound will be reduced by a certain unit. Since I want to make the sentence a bit more natural, I will turn the negative amount received from the change volume method to positive by adding a negative sign before the amount variable. So if the amount is negative, this part will become positive. If the amount is larger than zero, I will print a similar statement. But this time I don't need a negative sign here because the amount received from the use a change volume method is positive already. Okay, from these two classes, network device and television, I can create an internet TV, which is a combination of a network device and a television. So how can I do that? Here is the class declaration. I need to put the television class and the network device class in the parameter list of the Internet TV class. And then I can set up the initializer for Internet TV. An Internet TV would have all the components from the television and from the network device. In addition, an Internet TV has a central processing unit, so I have to add a new parameter to the initializer of the Internet TV class. Here, CPU is a new instance variable for the Internet TV object. Okay, Internet TV had some components similar to the network device. So I can simply call the network device initializer to help me instantiate Internet TV object. So the syntax is like this, network device dot underscore init underscore. And then I will pass the MAC number and cache size to the initializer of the network device. These two variables are actually the initializer of the network device shown on the above code. So when I pass these two values to the network device initializer, I will simply do these two lines for me. Okay. Same idea for the television component of an Internet TV. If I want to add some television components to an Internet TV, I use the television initializer. And you can check that a television class has two parameters for its initializer. And when I use the television initializer, I simply put these two parameters to the initializer path. So altogether, an Internet TV has five instance variables. And for a television, I can have some particular method to it. We can watch some TV programs from the network directory. I simply call the network device dot transmit method to do the data connection. Okay, when the transmission completes, the network TV is going to receive the data from the remote site. So we can use the network device.receive method to do the receipt of data. Of course, we know that this method will return a Boolean value true or false. So we can use a variable isReceived here to store the result coming from the network device.receive method. If isReceived is true, we do something like this. We display the video by calling the television.displayVideo method from the television class. Okay, let us instantiate an Internet TV here. A TV is an Internet TV. It has a number of components. So we have five arguments of an Internet TV. So when we pass these five arguments to the initializer of an Internet TV, all these three rules will be executed. Okay, I can tell the ATV to watch network TV by passing the argument value of 1. So the data size is 1 unit. And then I can tell the ATV to change the volume. The argument is minus 1, so I want to reduce the volume. And then I will ask the ATV object to watch the network TV again. For this time, the data size is 3 units. So let us try to run the code. Okay, for the first time, when we call the watch network TV method, the ATV object will request a download, and it is going to receive some data packets, and it can tell us that the screen is LED screen, and it is going to reduce the sound by 1 unit, and the second call of the watch network TV method is doing some similar thing. It requests a download first, but the receipt of the data will be aborted because the packet size is too large. So we can't put 3 units of data to the internet TV because the cache here is only 2 units of memory. So the receipt aborted prompt will be shown when we put 3 as the argument, but not for the first call, which is only having 1 as the argument. My implementation is intuitive and straightforward. However, it may not be the most efficient solution to the problem. If you can think about any idea to improve my code, feel free to post your code on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.